Think of the past as a sort of completed evolutionary experiment. With ancient DNA, we can ask how species and populations and entire ecosystems changed during the last ice age, during the first introduction of people into their habitats. We can learn from the past how we can better manage tremendous habitat change today. I'm Beth Shapiro. I am a professor in ecology and evolutionary biology and the co-director of the UCSC Paleogenomics Lab. So when working with ancient DNA, the most challenging thing we have to deal with is that the DNA that we're trying to recover is damaged. If I were to take a swab from my own cheek, I could get fragments of DNA that are millions, maybe even hundreds of millions of letters long. Our ancient samples, though, the fragments tend to be, if we're lucky, 100. A lot of our time is spent developing tools to try to figure out what it is that we've recovered from these bones and how to maximize the information that we can get from the DNA. We have better approaches now for transforming extracted DNA into the types of molecules that can be sequenced. A lot of that's been developed here in our research group. UCSC is internationally renowned for making new tools and new resources that are going to be available for people to work with. My research benefits from this. It benefits from the atmosphere of the Genomics Institute. It benefits from the collaborations in technology development, in population genomics. It's really a fantastic hub for the type of work that I'm doing. What I would like to be able to do with ancient DNA is to think of what we can do to actually stop species from becoming extinct, to predict what might happen in the future, and to project forward to a world that is both biodiverse and filled with people, because I think that's the world we want.